It's regulars.
I just want to be like non-distorted aspect ratio, basically. When we tilt it, I feel like we get like,
I wish we could do it something like that.
It's like my, like,
right here. Right. Yeah, that's a good, Well, that's a lot better. That's better.
Okay.
Or that's what I did when I left.
Okay, Eric, I think we've got things configured here. Located in there. Hey Eric, can you hear me? Hello? Testing 1, 2, 3. Thank you. We're waiting on Mike. He went to the bathroom real quick. He'll be back in a second. He's here.
Hey guys, good morning everybody. Today's live stream we're going to talk about something special. In the last few weeks, last few months, we did a lot of live streams. And we talked about mainboards, we talked about VGA, we talked about the gaming desktops. And a lot of times we had questions about our networking solutions, Killer LAN. So, you know, with Killer LAN, a lot of possibilities. So what we did today, we invited the guys from Killer Networking to explain to you what all the possibilities are, to answer questions. We will do a live demo. We will talk about all the technologies. And if you don't know Killer, maybe you remember this. This is from I think already 2005, and when I saw this I was really impressed, you know. It looked awesome, you know, like the Killer logo on the as a heatsink on a networking card. That was at that moment really awesome. And I think Killer did the same for networking what Creative did for audio, you know, for gaming. And I mean, that's also why we started with it. These guys are already long time in the business. They know what they're talking about. And it's not only about LAN solutions, but also about wireless solutions. Mike, Bob, are you already there? Are you already online? Hey, good morning.
Yes, sir, how's it going?
Everything's fine. So I understand you're based in the USA, so still very early morning.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
Rolling into.
One moment. Jeroen, zou je even dat ding weg kunnen klikken? Het staat op de achtergrond. Van Skype. Oh, niet dus. Oké. Okay, misschien dat scherm even stretchen. Yeah, sorry. I'm talking to the guy behind the computer to fix some things. So, today we're going to talk about Killer products, Killer networking products, as you say. So you're already from the beginning in the company?
Yes. So yeah, me and Bob were actually both founders of Bigfoot Networks, which happened in 2005, which brought you that awesome Killer M1 initial network card. We had a kind of an interesting company history. So we launched the Killer products, all kind of, you know, discrete add-in boards. Then in 2011, we actually got acquired by Qualcomm. In 2014, we were able to spin back out. And then from 2014 to today, we've been Rivet Networks, which has actually been really awesome. We've been able to really scale up the business, do a lot of new innovative things, and yeah, very excited to be partnered with you guys.
Yeah, sounds great. So today we also have a giveaway. Let's see that here. So we're going to give away three WRT32X gaming routers. So these are from Linksys. They're featuring the Killer chip. Later we will talk about this. And we're going to give away one Z270 Gaming M7 motherboard, also featuring Killer LAN. So guys, what do you need to do in order to make a chance to win this? We're live on Facebook, we're live on YouTube. Please, if you have any questions, interesting comments, suggestions, ask them in the live chat. We will be monitoring that. From time to time, we will pick somebody. And maybe, you know, if you have a really good question, you can be a winner of one of these awesome goods. So, let's maybe dive directly into the products. Because I believe you started with the LAN solution. So you had this add-in card already, 2005, right?
Yep.
That's a long time ago. And I remember a few years ago you introduced the E2400 LAN solution, which was integrated on the motherboards. And now one of your newest products is E2500, right?
That's right. Yep. We actually partnered with you on the launch of the E2500.
It's, I remember.
As the chart shows, it's just a fabulous part. One of the great things that the E2500 does is it really is focused on improving overall latency, overall system performance, and the overall online experience. So one thing that Killer is really, it's really integral to Killer's technology is we have the ability to detect what's going on in your system. We know the applications that are running, we know the websites you're on, and then because we know that, we can prioritize the applications and sites, and we can really shape the traffic for a great online experience. So, you know, one of the things that, you know, I've been gaming for, I don't want to admit for how many years because I'm getting old, But, you know, when I was younger and used to game, you used to turn everything off because you really didn't want to have anything going that could impact your latency. Well, now you don't have to do that with Killer. With Killer, because we can know you're playing a game, we know you have a download going on, we know you're watching a Twitch stream, we can actually prioritize that traffic so that your gaming packets never wait for your stream or your download. They're always first. They're always delivered fast. We keep your latency low.
So this is all done on the background automatically by the hardware and software?
It's automatic. It's automatic.
Okay.
I'm going to jump in with how it works, but it's automatic. The user doesn't have to do anything. We do ask users when they, you know, set up the system that they tell Killer there's a way in our control center to either test your bandwidth or enter in, you know, if you have 100 megabit or 50 megabit download speed. It helps us shape the traffic if we know the speed, but even if you don't, we'll still do a great job of it. Bandwidth is expensive. You know, I spend over $100 a month on my internet connection.
Yeah.
And I don't want to waste that bandwidth. So when I'm gaming or my kids are gaming, it's really nice to have Killer because you don't have to turn off those downloads. You don't have to turn off those streams, things like that.
Yeah, and just one thing to note, like most people don't know this, but games take about 30 kilobits a second. So you see these beautiful graphics, it looks good, everything's, you know, must be high throughput, right?
Yeah.
Well, it turns out games are only sending coordinate information back and forth as you're playing on a map and your video card's doing most of the hard work locally. So you actually, let's say you have a 50 or 100 megabit connection, 30 kilobits of it is your game, and the rest of it can be used for Twitch or, you know, whatever, Discord, whatever you got going on. So we absolutely want to make sure that we treat those 30 kilobits like gold, make sure everyone is fast, prioritized, and gives you that super real-time gaming experience. But at the same time, feel free to do Twitch. Feel free to download the next game patch, which sometimes takes forever. You know, be on Discord, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And you know, this chart you have showing up is a great example. Like, if you look at the latency chart on the left, what we're showing is, you know, what an average gamer would experience when they're multitasking. So if you have Killer, your latency is going to be low, even though you have a download going on. If you don't have Killer and you have sort of a standard NIC that's really been developed for, you know, the masses, then, you know, if your pipe gets full, packets are going to get dropped, they're going to get lost, they're going to have to be re-delivered. And what happens is when those packets are dropped or lost, it's totally random. With Killer, we make sure we never drop a gaming packet. And the result is that competitors have really high latency when your system's busy compared to Killer.
Now, do you see, because I play a lot of Battlefield and I see some servers are like 30, like intervals they update and now they're going to 60, you know, so the synchronization is better, that there's no lag or clipping in the game. Do you see this increasing with newer games?
Yeah, it's interesting. So basically latency is made up of three different things. It's made up of your PC, the network, and then the game server on the other side.
Yeah.
And so our view is we can do a perfect job of, you know, fixing the PC. Then the other part of it is what we do is we actually tag packets. So we say, hey, look, we're going to tag this packet as high priority so the rest of the network actually knows your Killer packet is important. So as you go through all the different carriers and the backbone, your packet is prioritized above other things in the network. And then there's the game server on the other side, which is one of the areas like right now that, you know, we don't have a lot of influence on. But our view is if you get packets there first to the game server via the network and prioritizing at the PC, your packet's going to be processed first and you're going to have an advantage versus other people playing that game.
Yeah, there's nothing more annoying than, you know, trying to shoot somebody and you miss because you skip a few frames or the game is updated because of some lag.
Yeah, this is the other interesting part. Your freezing on your PC, especially your MSI notebook or desktop, is usually not because your NVIDIA graphics card can't handle it or your i7 or i8 can't handle it. It's because you're having a network glitch. So one of the things that drives us just nuts is when people, you know, really skimp on the networking piece of it. You know, they buy this like $500 graphics card, and then, you know, they buy like a low-end wired or wireless product to play their game. That blood that comes into your PC, that lifeline to the game, I mean, the speed is really your networking at this point. And your point, it's emotional. When your video freezes, when your game lags, when, you know, you're on Discord or on Skype and you hear like the voice stutter. I mean, that's an emotional, and you're mad, right? You get really upset.
And tell me about it.
Is absolutely, you know, going with Killer can save a lot of those problems for you.
Yeah, I have some questions on the live stream. Somebody is saying Killer doesn't work in CS:GO. It only makes it worse. Do you know anything about this?
No, absolutely not. We test with a suite of about 50 games. CSGO is absolutely a game we test with that we play in-house. We do a pretty good job with CSGO, especially when things are going on. If there is, by the way, just as an open invitation, if anyone does have a problem, please reach out to us, killersupport@rivetnetworks.com. We would love to help you, but there is absolutely no reason that you should have any problem with CSGO. And if you are having a problem, please reach out. We'd love to help you out.
In fact, with CSGO is actually the game we used to highlight in our E2500 video that we did at Modge. And it's a pretty easy test if anyone wants to do it. All you need to do is fill up your pipe, check what your latency is with Killer on. And by fill up your pipe, I mean get downloads going, watch a stream, see how much, make sure that if you've got a 50 megabit connection, you've got 50 megabits going through. And then turn Killer off through the settings. There's an advanced stream detect. Just turn it off.
Yeah.
Once you turn it off, we behave like any other networking product. And you'll see the latency go up, and we have video demonstrations on YouTube, on our website.
I just posted your website on both chats, in Facebook and YouTube, so people can also go there. And especially, I'm very happy that you're so open for support, because I think this is important. You know, there are a lot of vendors, you know, they put a product on the market, they don't listen to the market. You guys are really open for feedback, and you know, if there's a problem, you know, try to get it to you guys and try it, and you will fix it. And I think that's very important because games are coming out, and I see also in the chat a lot of people, you know, somebody, let me scroll back, he says, I don't buy MSI because about their annoying program, and he's referring to your software or drivers, you know. And I know in the past with Windows 8, there were a lot of problems with drivers, right?
Yeah, so a few things. When we came out as Rivet Networks, obviously we were actually able to increase the size of our company, our support staff, by a lot. So over the last 3 or 4 years, we feel like our products have been of very high quality. But just to be clear, our new software, anything out in the last few years, our app in the background, when it's not up, doesn't take any resources. There is nothing that we ever do to get in the way. So if you like first of all, we know a lot of people that like the app. It's great. If you don't like the app, I wouldn't open it. There's no reason to. But there is the only thing that we do when it comes to the path of your packet is for certain types of packets, we basically accelerate them by saying, hey, look, there's what happens normally with networking is you have a queue, which is a bunch of different packets from a bunch of different apps go to this like queue, which is like a dump truck. You know, they try to fill up the back of the dump truck.
Yeah.
Then when they get full, they dump all the packets into your system. What Killer does says is, hey, look, if I get a gaming packet in the back of my dump truck, I'm just going to dump it real quick. You know, I'm going to let that thing go in there fast. So there is nothing that Killer does or nothing that the app does that would ever slow down a game. It is a very, very lightweight path to taking your from the server to your game and cutting out all of the middlemen and all of the basically interference that would cause that packet to slow down.
Yeah. Hey, and Eric, one thing I also want to add on the support angle is, you know, our website is killernetworking.com, and on the support page, we typically do this in the U.S. during business hours, which works out to Europe to be evening, which is real, I believe, pretty convenient for gamers in Europe.
Absolutely, yeah. Most people are online after school and in the evening.
Agreed. And so in the evening time in Europe, if you go to our support tab, when our support staff is there, they turn on the live chat button. So you can email us, you can do live chat, we make it very easy to get support.
Well, what I believe is, you know, a lot of these bad experience or presumptions, you know, they're based on the past. Because I remember that, you know, I'm already like 16 years in MSI, and I remember in the beginning, everything was good and Windows 8 came out, there were a lot of driver problems. But, you know, this is fixed, and a lot of people still have this experience. So, also you totally revamped your software, looks awesome. Later we'll do a live demo, we will look at that. So really intuitive to use. So I think a lot of people, they should give it a try again. And like what you said with Counter-Strike, you know, try it with the killer software and without the killer software and experience the difference.
Absolutely. And one other thing I'd just like to note there is, again, I think over the last 3 or 4 years, quality has been obviously our most important thing that we're working towards, and I think we've been really pretty good. But the other thing I would add to this is Windows with Windows updates now. So Windows 10 is automatically updating all the time in the background unless you've done something to turn it off. My recommendation is every 3 to 6 months, especially with wireless products, that you go to our website, go to MSI, and download the latest drivers. Because what's happening is Microsoft is making a lot of real-time changes. We actually work incredibly closely with Microsoft on, you know, their latest changes and make sure everything's correct. But you just can't go 2 or 3 years without upgrading drivers. So just as a general service announcement, I would say, because of Win 10, because of those constant updates, do go out there, update your wired and wireless drivers every 3 to 6 months.
Yeah. So you're talking about wireless. You also have a wireless product, the 1550 AC product. I think it just launched at CES.
Yes, just launched with you guys at CES.
Yeah.
This is a really cool product. It's actually, well, a couple things. It's the first 160 megahertz product in the market. And what that basically means is the amount of spectrum that you have to send wireless is actually twice as big as a standard 2x2 AC card. So if you see on the chart on your screen, the theoretical throughput's about 1.7 gigabits over wireless, which is faster than most wired products out there today.
Absolutely.
In the real world, we get about 1.2, 1.3 as long as your router supports 160, so it's gigabit plus Wi-Fi.
Yeah, and I see also Intel logo, so this is the first product you did together with Intel. Can you explain a little bit about that? Because in the past, you made your own hardware, or how should I see this?
So in the past, what we did was we partnered with Qualcomm. So we actually co-designed hardware with Qualcomm as we were, you know, previously part of that company. And then it was interesting. We've had a long kind of relationship with Intel, kind of going back and forth of, you know, could we work together? Could we not work together? And in Intel, we both did kind of our due diligence. They went out and, you know, thought about developing their own systems, partnering with other people. We kind of did the same on the hardware standpoint. Yep. And finally, we came to the conclusion that it would be best to work together. So what we think the Killer 1550 is the absolute latest and greatest, you know, Intel chipset optimized for Killer. And it's the greatest and, you know, perfect Killer traffic management engine and traffic shaping engine. So you put those two things together and you got the best of both worlds. There's been, you know, our experiences in the past, there's kind of this, like, I love Intel camp and there's this I love Killer camp.
Yeah.
This is absolutely the best of both worlds.
Yeah.
So as you
watch
this Intel hardware, this product has it and has all of our killer stuff on top of it.
Yeah. I have some Marvin, interesting question. What if I have an old PC and I use Killer? Would it help my lag?
If you get the 1550, is that the...
Not really particular. It could be either LAN or wired, let's say like that, wired or wireless.
Yeah, I mean, everything that we've done, especially with our new Killer Control Center, has gotten a lot better. So if you, yes, it should absolutely help your leg. I will tell you that a couple cool things we've done to make it even better is we now detect not only applications, so your game, your Skype, your Outlook, your Steam download, we now detect individual websites. So for example, you can be watching YouTube or Netflix, you have, you know, news websites on there, you have other things. We can actually prioritize YouTube over a download site, over a normal news and media site. And then we do it automatically, but if a user wants to change all those things, those are completely in, you know, the user's ability to do that. So that's a new feature that, you know, should, you know, so not only will it help with lag and latency of your game and kind of your applications, but we can actually help on individual websites too, which is a big change that we've made in the last kind of year.
I have another question. Let me check this. What is the most thing you would want to focus on the future of Killer boards? I mean, what to be developed and added to the network. So he's actually asking, what is your future plan?
That's awesome. So we have, that's one of the, I mean, it sounds interesting, but moving from Qualcomm to Rivet, that's one of the most exciting things, is we've been able to really increase our research and development. I think you'll see two kind of main areas for us going forward. One is, how do we make your game play the fastest it possibly can, reduce all latency, and even put your system in a state that says, hey, look, I'm playing a game, I'm doing the right things to optimize your game. The other thing that I would kind of mention is we have a new technology that, you know, we launched with you guys at last CES called Killer Extend. And one of our views of the world, and we'll talk about this a little bit more, is your PC is the most powerful device in your house. I mean, your MSI gaming PC, there is no more powerful chip in your house than the Intel i7, i8 that's in there, or 8 series or 7 series. And letting your PC do more. So for example, with Extend, we actually put a switch in the back of your PC. So 3 Ethernet and a Wi-Fi. the Ethernet can be used not only to create internet access for your PC, but also as a switch, so you can actually connect your Xbox or your other nearby connected device to your gaming PC to get internet access. And then you can do the same thing with the wireless. You can go out there and actually hook up to the MSI PC.
So, yeah, everything is going to work together.
Yes.
You have a more like an integrated hub router.
Yeah, I would call it more of access, so like, yeah, you know, switch and a Wi-Fi extender. But the nice part about all of that stuff is not only do you get access, but we prioritize your killer game packets above all the other connected devices in your home. So what happens now a lot of times is Killer does an awesome job on your PC. We tag packets for your router, but your router is still kind of the weakest link inside of your home right now.
Yeah.
What this does is it really streamlines the traffic going to your router by Killer being able to take some of that traffic in and then make sure the Killer gaming packets are prioritized above it all.
I think we also have a slide about that. So maybe let me take out this board because...
Okay. Godlike.
This is the godlike motherboard. So we have a lot of products with Killer on board. We have notebooks, we have desktops, and this is the Z370 gaming of a godlike gaming. So let me unpack it. It's a really nice product, and it actually has the feature what Mike is talking about. So I think it's called Killer Extend, right?
That's right. Yeah. And this is a great example of the partnership between the companies too.
So this board, as you can see in the back, it has three LAN connectors and wireless connectors.
Yep.
So, and with this, you can connect everything in your house together.
That's right. So, you know, for example, my living room has the gaming computer. It has the Xbox. It has a media file server that we use. I can connect everything with cables that I can to those three ports. Whatever I can't get to those ports via cable, I can connect wirelessly. Once those things get to the computer, of course, that has the godlike board in it, what it can then do is it prioritizes the killer traffic, like Mike said, above all the other traffic coming in. And it's actually a little bit more sophisticated. It prioritizes the important traffic, the urgent traffic, over that connected device traffic. If you've got a download or something going on, we can actually put the download below the other connected device traffic so that the download won't slow down like a video or something, a game playing on an Xbox or something like that. But what we end up doing with this is we end up giving the user to really take charge of, their home networking experience and ensure that their gaming packets are above everything else that they have connected. So we actually have a lot of people that try to route things through this godlike board because it gives them more control than a lot of routers can give them.
Yeah. So, probably we're going to see more products like this in the future, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And another nice thing in addition to that is, that's actually saving you money, in our view, from your computer taking the place of maybe a switch and a Wi-Fi extender. At the same time, our double shot feature of letting you, if you do want to make them all connected to your actual router or network, you can actually, smartly choose, like in our app, how Double Shot Pro works, which means you're taking advantage of more than one link on your system, is you can now prioritize, priorities 1 and 2 go over Ethernet 1, priority 3 go over Ethernet 2, priorities, 5 goes over Ethernet 3, and priority 6 goes over Wi-Fi. You now have the ability to choose every single application or website which link that traffic goes over. And what we try to do automatically for you is just say, hey, we want the fastest, the game, for example, to go over the fastest link, which in general is Ethernet, but is becoming more likely, Wi-Fi is getting a lot faster. So we want to make sure, that game packet, again, not only are we getting it out the fastest, but it's taking the fastest link back to your router to make sure you're getting the absolute fastest gaming experience.
Is that also what you see as a trend? Because you say wireless is getting faster, so this also means the upstream needs to get faster. Do you see more fiber connections?
Sure.
Penetration?
Two steps to that. One for wireless latency. So we actually do system latency now. And on a killer product, the system latency of getting a packet in and out of your PC is now under a millisecond with wireless, and it's about a quarter of a millisecond with wired. So that is incredibly fast.
Yeah.
Now, so your game is basically playing 3/4 of a millisecond slower with wireless, which is certainly measurable, but the gap is really narrowed. The second piece of this is, is your actual internet connection. Things like fiber will always be faster. Bigger is always usually better, because not only for your own home, but it turns out the carriers, if they can offer you a bigger service, they usually have more capabilities in their network and at their different exchange points to be able to handle your traffic. So bigger is better, not because you actually need all the bandwidth, just usually because the rest of the network infrastructure behind the bigger is usually better. But filler works great on a low network too. You're hoping the rest of the network isn't swamped if you have a small connection from a small provider.
Yeah. So let's go back to the giveaway. I just gave away one router to Adnan. He was a little bit hesitating to post his email address. Adnan, so you won one of the killer routers. Yeah, really nice. So you already have half of your killer setup at home. Connect everything together and you will have an awesome, smooth gaming experience. So you can delete your gaming email address. I copy it, and I will later in the week, I will contact you by email to give you all the details and get your address. So thanks for the questions. So if anybody has some questions left, please ask them in the chat. From time to time, we will pick out an interesting one, and then I will ask you to post your email address, and later you can delete your email address. Let's go to some other questions. A lot of questions here. Wow. Oh, interesting one. Can you buy a killer separately for your PC? So, I mean, we as MSI, we offer them in our products. So in the main board, as you can see, it's this one is very difficult to see, but it's located over here. I will not use my middle finger. Last streams I was pointing with my middle finger, but I got some comments on that. So this finger, so it's located around here near the I/O panel. Also for the Wi-Fi module, the Wi-Fi module is located over here. Notebooks integrated as well, desktops integrated, so they all come with killer.
Yep.
We have also products based without killer. The killer products normally are in the high-end, mid-range product segment. So, but what if you have already a gaming PC at home and you still want to use killer?
So a couple things. That's one of the biggest misconceptions about us today is people, remember some of the discrete products that we sold and basically think that experience is what they're going to get today. I would tell you we've come a long way both on performance, quality, and price. Mm-hmm. So our initial products were very expensive. Once we were able to get partnerships, like with MSI, we have a 5x5 millimeter chip, which is our Ethernet chip.
That's why you couldn't find it.
Yep, which I can tell you is why the cost of our solutions come down dramatically from the earlier days, but the value has actually gone up. We currently do not offer any discrete Ethernet products. In certain regions, just with the 1550, we've started selling the 1550 standalone. I will tell you that if you want to replace in a notebook over time, that would typically work. The M.2 slot on most motherboards is not actually wired up for Wi-Fi. In some it is, but in most it's wired up for an SSD or something like that.
Yeah.
So be very careful. If you have any questions, again, reach out to us at Killer Support if you're looking to upgrade your Wi-Fi. But in general, no, the best way to get them is to go out there and buy an MSI motherboard or notebook that has a Killer already integrated.
So very difficult to upgrade.
Yep.
Let me check some other questions. This is Chris. He has a question. He's a little bit hesitating because, everything in this business, technology business, is moving so fast. If you buy a border product, it's actually already old. So he's saying, what are the changes from the old wireless one to the new one? And, what can I expect next? So he's a little bit hesitating about buying a new product. I think you just introduced the 1550, so I think your new products will probably be half year or even longer, right?
So
that's a good question.
Yeah, that's a great question, because this 2019 will be an incredibly exciting year for networking as new technologies come out later in the year. But the 1550 today as major advantages. First of all, AC, 11AC is fast and really good. It's really matured as a technology. Again, we're getting over gigabit speeds on Wi-Fi now. The 1550 has Bluetooth 5.0, so you've kind of future-proofed yourself for some Bluetooth, better throughput, better connectivity. But I think the thing that has really impressed me the most with Wi-Fi over the past years is, one, just the size has gotten incredibly small. So you can put it in very thin, very light notebooks. And then two is just the robustness. If you think about And this is just one of the problems with, you know, Intel, Realtek, Qualcomm, whoever. Wireless is hooking up to thousands of different access points with thousands of different types of technology, whether it be BGN, 11AC, all different models in all different countries with different regulatory settings. And it works really incredibly well. So, you know, watch out of time, there's quality issues. If you think about how highly variable your Wi-Fi needs to deal with when it looks at all the different things it has to connect to in the world, we think the quality of 11AC is much, much better than NG, previous AC products. It's just a really robust product at this point. I mean, you think about Intel or NVIDIA, they're kind of in a controlled environment. They're always running the same things. I mean, they're incredibly fast and incredibly advanced. But, I mean, Wi-Fi has to hook up to everything at every different time and different networks, different carriers, and the quality has just gone through the roof.
And one thing to think about with the particular Intel chip that we partnered with the 1550, is that it's their fifth generation AC part. I mean, they came out with four, you know, generations before, and this one, we love it. It's solid, it's fast. And, you know, what we sponsor some streamers here in the U.S., and one of the things, you know, we're even hearing from them is, holy cow, I can actually stream with this. And when I mean stream, I mean upload my stream to the game. I mean to the server so other people can watch them, because it's getting fast enough, it's getting reliable enough. And one of the big problems with wireless 2 or 3 years ago is it was so variable. And, of course, wireless is still, you know, more variable than Ethernet, but it's gotten a lot better. The other thing that, you know, if someone came and asked me, should I buy the 1550, an MSI with the 1550? Should I wait? I would be really comfortable recommending that if they're kind of on the fence, to take the plunge. And the reason is you really have a lot of future proofing in with the 1550. And the reason is that a lot of the routers, because Wi-Fi is getting faster, a lot of the router vendors are going to start putting 2.5 gig switches into routers. And, you know, we've seen some of that happen already. We believe we'll see more and more of that happen. And if you get a system with 1550 in it, as those routers come out, you'll be fully supported, ready to go, and be able to take advantage of the speeds that they offer. So,
Angela, let me...
kind of surprised, you know. I'm also getting old, you know, still playing games. And I always advise everybody, you know, why have Wi-Fi on a motherboard, you know? Why have Wi-Fi on a desktop? On a notebook, I can understand. But so what you guys actually are saying, that Wi-Fi will give me more benefit than Wi-Fi in like maybe already at this moment?
In some cases, certainly. I mean, still you need, there's some physics out there that says you need to be within a certain range of your router and things like that. But given if you have, you know, 100% or 95% signal strength, wireless is really good. And that's one of the hardest things for us to tell people is, you know, everyone's like, you know, Ethernet is so much faster, so much better. And it is a little faster, and it is less variable. But Wi-Fi is getting a lot better. So, you know, if you're playing casual games and want to put your PC someplace where you don't have to run a wire all through your house or whatever it is, we do think wireless is a pretty good option.
Yeah.
The other thing I was going to mention, one more thing for the last question, is the two new technologies that are coming out next year that we think are pretty exciting, just as where we're going, is there is a new generation of Wi-Fi coming out next year.
It's AX, right?
Really cool stuff. It's actually a little bit faster, which is good. But what it does, the other major advantage it has, is dealing in dense environments. So right now, one of the problems with Wi-Fi is it just tries to overpower people. So it's a constant, you know, trying to bang other packets out of the air. And because it's really strong, so it wins a lot of those battles. But in a perfect world, it'd be more coordinated. So with 11AX, they're actually going to use cellular technology to figure out who sends which packet when. And so the marketing message there is, in a dense environment, think a Starbucks or a university or an apartment complex, you can actually get four times more usable throughput. So,
or a LAN party, game LAN party.
Yeah, LAN party would be a perfect one. Yeah. So just to let you know, that's kind of the future of Wi-Fi in the next kind of 1 to 2 years. And then on the Ethernet side, I think you'll start seeing some pretty mainstream multi-gigabit parts coming out in 2019 and beyond. And the real thing about multi-gigabit that you care about, to Bob's earlier point, is, you know, you can use them in a lot of cases, but if you have a switch or a router that supports 2.5, 5, or 10, that's when you've really kind of been able to truly, you know, benefit from that technology in a wide way. So we are excited about multi-gigabit and its future for Ethernet.
Yeah. Okay. I have somebody saying, hey, I really like the godlike motherboard. This one, Lorenzo. But it's a little bit expensive. Yeah, true. This is one of the high-end motherboards, of course, you know. With the new technology, Killer Extend. That's also why I have it here, to show you, talk about it and show you what it's doing. But of course, Killer, you know, we have in several price brackets. And if you talk, for example, about Z270, Gaming M5, Gaming M3, you know, these kind of products also have Killer LAN on board. So they come at an affordable price level. It's not, you know, that you have to pay like this. I don't know the price exactly, but that you have to pay buy the premium products over there to get Killer. So please keep that in mind. Do they use their own service? Kat, can you maybe explain a little bit more? It's, giveaway is already ongoing, so if you have any interesting questions, but please be clear, do they use their own service? I don't know. Well, so maybe you're not happy about the service? Please be more clear. So let's maybe talk, because you already touched a little bit about Killer Double Shot. I want to talk about that. Also prepared some graphics for that. So Killer Double Shot is actually, if you have a LAN connector and you can combine it with your wireless connector at the same time. So then you call this Double Shot, right? Double Shot Pro.
You got it. And Double Shot is really, it's kind of an obvious use case, but we can do a lot of, you know, interesting, cool things with it. So yes, it's being able to use both Wi-Fi and Ethernet at the same time, yeah, which you can do in a normal Windows setting. And then beyond that, it's being really smart. So we can, I mean, this actually is incredibly smart. So we can say, if you're hooked up to both wireless and Ethernet, I'm going to send certain types of traffic over Ethernet, certain types of traffic over Wi-Fi. That's one advantage. The second advantage is, and we automatically do that for you, or you can set it yourself. The second thing we do is we let you use both connections at the same time. So being able to get, you know, theoretically up to, with a Killer Wireless 15.
I have some graphic for that as well.
Yeah, so there's a lot of throughput there.
Yeah.
So that's, yeah, up to 2.7 gigabits worth of throughput, which is huge. And the other cool part about this is we do some smart things from a health standpoint, and we're going to do more in the future. So we can say things like, if your wireless signal strength goes below a certain number, meaning we know your experience isn't that good, we're automatically going to switch that traffic back over to wired.
Okay, and so it's automatically managing the traffic and takes the best route. And do you have some examples? Because, for example, we have here an example. It says Overwatch via LAN, YouTube via Wi-Fi. Is it based on signal strength or based on how much bandwidth it's using?
This is usually based on latency. So our number one goal is to make that game and those things play fast. So what we'll basically do is we'll say, hey, Overwatch, my goal is to get you to the router and to the network as fast as humanly possible. And I know that Ethernet has a very small advantage, but look, as it goes through the whole network, that can turn into a bigger advantage. So latency-sensitive stuff goes over, you know, wired first. And then over wireless, we say, hey, look, these are also important apps. We want to make sure we kind of have a dedicated, strong connection. But they can deal with an extra millisecond worth of latency or an extra 2 milliseconds worth of latency. But the good news is you're getting more throughput in and out of your machine. Another interesting, you know, example of throughput is you're actually able to hook up to two different networks at the same time. So if you have let's call it a home broadband network, and then there's public Wi-Fi or your phone's Wi-Fi or, you know, whatever it is, or your neighbor's Wi-Fi for your whatever, you can actually hook up to both at the same time and actually get more broadband throughput in and out of your system. So not only from your home broadband connection, but also from your phones, your neighbors, your public.
Yeah. And to really benefit this, do I need to have two upstreams? Because if you're having one upstream to your home or one uplink, whatever you want to call it, and, you know, in the back, everything is still going via the same connector or connection.
Sure. I would argue two things. One is you can hook up to two different broadband networks if you have access.
Mm-hmm.
And the second one is how I use it in my house is I have one hooked up to a media server and the other one hooked up to my broadband connection. So I have a 200 gigabit broadband connection. I'm playing games, doing videos, downloading stuff, and the other one is actually a media server where I'm transferring files or watching things from that actual media server. And so I got up to a gigabit or whatever I hook it up with, but usually let's call it wireless that way of a gigabit, or wireless of, you know, 800 megabits or 700 megabits, and I got wired with the rest of it to my home broadband connection. and then I'm actually getting two different sources of information in a pretty standard use case.
And Eric, I have a funny thing situation where I live. My parents actually live next door to me, so I actually connect to the Ethernet to my own router, and Wi-Fi I connect over to my parents' Wi-Fi.
So stealing that bandwidth.
Well, they never use it, right? I mean, they use email. That's really about it. And so I literally connect to two different networks, and it works out great for me, especially when I need to, get a lot of traffic going. I actually can literally keep my game on a complete different network than, everything else going on in my system. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I have a question from Nicolas Thomas. He's asking, what router works best with KillerLAN? I know what you're going to answer, but later we're going to talk about the Linksys router, but does it matter?
I would say there's a lot
except
of routers
for this
great
one.
With
besides
it.
This one, you know?
Yeah, the Killer router is obviously great, but in general, if you use an 11AC class router, so one of the things that happened when you went from N to AC is the routers got bigger processors with better horsepower. Just in general, that's not like one particular brand. If you can upgrade to an AC class router, usually let's call it like an AC 1900 and above, I would say that is your best chance of not only having good Wi-Fi, but having good Ethernet LOM also, because just the processor in that router is better. But if you can't go there, I would say, most AC routers have the processing power to be really good. The N routers are just getting a little old. What's happened is your broadband connection's getting so much faster in most cases. That being able to process 100 or 200 megabits or more becomes harder on those old N processors. And that's just a statement of those are 5-year-old processors now. They're not near as fast.
Yeah.
So, I would recommend if you get to an AC router, definitely do it. An AC 1900 and above, because kind of generally speaking is probably where you want to be if you want really good performance.
So maybe let's talk about the killer router. It's a Linksys router. Is there a killer chip inside, or is it the software which is helping the priorities over here?
It's actually software. So the first time we met with Linksys, it was kind of like Intel. We were both feeling each other out. They didn't have a gaming router, and we met with the guy who heads up their WRT routers over there. And it was really interesting how we both realized our companies had very common goals, especially towards the gaming market. They wanted to build a router that was genuinely built for gaming. There's some routers out there that claim, we've got, all these antennas, all these ports, it's great for gaming. And that's not a bad thing to have those, but it doesn't mean that it's built for gaming. So what we did is we partnered with them and we said, look, one of the things we do is we identify the traffic and we tag the packets and send them up. And frankly, routers often, don't look at how the packets are tagged or do anything based on that. So what we did was we built an engine, we put it in their router. It is software, and what it does is it does a few things. The first, it does device detection, and it says, hey, listen, am I talking to a killer device? And if it is, it says, great, I'm going to start listening to packets. And so if we send it a game, communication like Skype or streaming video, what it's going to do is it's going to prioritize those three things above regular home traffic. So if my girlfriend or child is doing something, consuming a lot of bandwidth, if you're using a killer with the killer prioritization engine on the router, it will actually prioritize these packets in such a way that your gaming experience isn't affected by your kid downloading the latest Fortnite patch. And at the same point, if I'm downloading the latest Fortnite patch on my killer system, the software, the engine on the router is smart enough to know, hey, listen, I can prioritize this download below, my kid's game who's playing, or my roommate's,
And so this stream. Killer router will already work when I don't have a killer LAN or Wi-Fi solution, but will it even work better when you have that at home?
It will. The cool thing is with killers that we're always making it better and we're always improving. So the next thing that you're going to see with this killer, and this will be available for people who will purchase it or who have purchased it and should go sometime this summer, is that we're actually going to move some detection to the router itself. So Killer's always going to tell the router what the traffic is. It will always do that, and the router will always prioritize it appropriately. But we've got an improvement coming to the router via a firmware upgrade that will allow the router to detect other things itself on systems that may or may not have Killer in them. So so if you don't have Killer, you know, first of all, you should probably get Killer. But yeah. If you don't, you know, if you get this router, it will also do a good job, you know, starting with that firmware upgrade of detecting, hey, I've got a game going on, you know, another MSI motherboard or notebook that may not have Killer. And it will be able to do some detection there. It will do packet tagging and things like that at the router.
One quick thing to note, too, is you can actually log into your Killer Control Center, and when it senses a router, it automatically pops up a tab that lets you control certain aspects of the router from your Killer Control Center versus having to, like, 192.168 an IP address. And we don't think the router user experience is, you know, first of all, this Linksys router has a pretty decent UI, but in general, router UIs are hard to deal with. So yeah. We are taking some of that functionality, moving it to the Killer Control Center, and making it easier for
so
the
from
user.
One central place, everything you can manage regarding your network.
Yeah. Yeah.
Interesting. Another question from Marek. He is asking, you know, we already talked about it. This is more in premium products, mid-range and premium products available, not in the entry level. Are you going to have a killer version for cheaper budget boards? Boards, motherboards, he's asking, but can also be desktops.
We work a lot with our best partners on trying to get there. There is a premium for Killer. You know, we do a lot of stuff and have a lot of differentiation in there, but that's something we're working towards. So if you think about it, over, like, you know, 5 years ago, we were only on incredibly expensive motherboards.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've moved down, I think, to the mid-range pretty well, and we are absolutely trying to create a new class of products where I don't think we'll ever be on the cheapest systems, but certainly we want to hit kind of a lower price point as we hit, you know, you can get a pretty good gaming PC for a lot less now as the rest of the technology catches up. So we want to have a killer product that targets there too.
Yeah.
So something we're definitely working.
Okay, so there you have your answer. Let me see. Does this allow me to use my onboard Ethernet jack without having to buy an external LAN card? That's a strange
So everything Killer now is a LAN chip on the motherboard. Buy a Killer motherboard with an E2500 or an E2400 and you will absolutely, no need for a discrete card.
Yeah.
The surprising part is we haven't sold a discrete card since 2010, so LAN is the way to do it.
Sheriff, to you, does this router really matter for speed? So we're talking about Linksys router. It was more or less already answered, right?
I'm sorry, can you repeat that question one more time?
The question is, does this router really matter for the speed? And I believe we're talking about the Linksys router, but this was more or less already answered, right? It's about prioritization of the traffic.
Yeah, so the Linksys router has a couple advantages. One is yes, it absolutely does a great job of prioritizing killer traffic from the killer device in and out of the home. The other nice part is it pairs up really nicely with the 1550, as this router does support 160 megahertz channels. So this is a router where it has a gigabit switch, but you can get full gigabit Wi-Fi from this router with a killer 1550.
Okay, yeah. So I just reminded everybody in the chat, you know, you can today you can win some awesome products. If you have some good questions, we will select some questions. So then you can either win one of the Linksys routers or one of the Z270 Gaming M7 motherboards. So maybe talk, because we talked about the products. So here I have a GT75, which is a notebook. It's one of our high-end notebooks.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's really awesome. You know, it has SLI in a notebook, nice keyboard, RGB LED, keyboard with SteelSeries. But also comes with Killer. And I want to do a little bit live demo. So maybe switch to the live environment, Jeroen. Capture this notebook. I hope everything works, you know, it's always... Yep.
Demos are always interesting, Eric.
It's terrible, you know. I started Battlefield that crashed this morning. Yesterday everything went okay, but we will see. When you go to your sys tray and there is a killer logo, you click on it, you get the software. So, I'm not really an expert, so I'm just going to tell what I see and just jump in. And if you have everything of anything what you want to add, or if I'm saying anything wrong, you know, just interrupt me and...
we'll be glad.
Yeah, so what I see here, I'm connected now at the same time to the MSI mobile network. So that's the wireless network here, and to the MSI wired network. So this is actually basically what you're talking about DoubleShot, right? DoubleShot Pro.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay, so when I have a normal notebook, and you know, my experience is always when I connect to the Wi-Fi, but I plug in my wired cable, cable, then my Wi-Fi is disconnected. So is this something special for Killer that you can do this at the same time, or is some trick I can also do this in Windows?
No, we have no idea how to do it in Windows. Yeah, so it's basically a special Killer technology that we use to be able to enable both and then smartly choose between each link with different types of traffic.
Yeah, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to disconnect the wired, the cable. You can see it over here. And now you only have the mobile solution. So let me see. Not sure if it has any connection. Well, it probably will come back. Yeah, where was that again? So now I plugged it back, and then it will automatically detect the wired network. Okay, so let's go through it a little bit. So here I have an overview. I can see some speed indicators. When I go to settings, I think this is also interesting. You need to set a speed limit. I tried to do the bandwidth test, but I think here, due to the firewall configuration, it doesn't work. They blocked it. Our system administrators, this is our office network. So, but normally at home, you can do a bandwidth test. So what I did, I went to speed test online and I filled in. And I think this is important in the beginning, because normally it says you have like 500 megabyte per second or something connection. Can you explain a little bit why this is so important?
So two things. One, we put a big number in there because our view is we never want to slow down your internet connection ever. But if we know exactly how big your internet connection is, we can do smart things like say, let's say you have 20 megabits. And I know a YouTube takes 8 megabits, a game takes, 30 kilobits, and a download takes the rest. But what it lets me do is it helps me shape that traffic perfectly to make sure each app is getting what it should. If we don't know what it is, we still do a good job of prioritizing packets in general, but it's harder to shape and kind of allocate traffic between different apps. So entering that in is certainly helpful.
Yeah, okay. So, and this is the same for the wired connection. It was also on 500. I put it on 50, 10 after some, everything is kept here. So, they don't want me to use the network downloading something too big.
Can't imagine why.
So here I have a button, advanced stream detect. Can you maybe explain a little bit what this is doing?
So that basically turns on Killer prioritization and traffic shaping. So if you have it on, we're automatically shaping, prioritizing, treating everything great. If you don't want it on for any reason, you can turn it off and it will disable that feature for you.
Okay. I have a question, a question from Stabor Nation, of the Stabor Nation. Does the MSI X470 Gaming M7AC is it also compatible with the Linksys gaming router with Killer enabled? Yes, this is completely compatible. Both have a Killer solution, so it will work optimal. Like what we just talked about with Mike and Bob, you can really benefit from all the traffic shaping. Each package is tagged, so you have the best. So you have the best, questions are coming in. You have the best, smoothest network experience, let's say like that. I think this is a good question, right, Stibor? Ask him for his email address. Mike, Bob?
Cool. Yeah, sure, yeah.
Okay. Stibor, one moment.
It's great. We have such an active audience today.
So I just asked him for his email address. I hope you can post it. We have a Linksys gaming router with Killer in there. So I think if you already have the X470 Gaming M7 or are planning to use it, you know, with this you have the optimal setup. So if you post your email address, I will copy it and then you can delete it. I will give you a message when I copy it. So thanks for the question. So let's go back to the Killer Control Center. Over here I also have DoubleShot Pro. Do I need to enable this manually or disable it manually? How does this work exactly?
You need to enable it. It's a feature that you need to turn on.
Okay.
Yep.
Nothing will go wrong if I click yes, right? If I click on. Yep.
Correct. Nothing will go wrong. It'll be off.
Okay, I see here an access point list. Let me see.
So what this does is it basically says, you know, we set your bandwidth, or we like to know your bandwidth per access point. So as you go from home, school, to work, it just keeps track of it, and then you can...
Okay, so in the notebook, you can travel around, and everywhere you have the optimized speed already. Nice.
Yep.
Download latest app priorities. So basically, this is a list on which you define... maybe you can explain.
Yeah, so there's a couple of things. One is Killer does an awesome job of automatically detecting new games and a lot of new things. And that's a big difference between us and especially some router technologies that do an initial whitelist and the thing ends up being old and crappy real fast. So we automatically detect every new game and a lot of different apps. But the update priority list basically says, hey, look, if there is something new or maybe a website becomes more popular and all that kind of stuff, you can actually go in there, push that, and you're guaranteed you have the absolute latest detection for absolutely everything that we do. And it's just a quick file. So it downloads a really small file, replaces the current.
I just did it, and it's there. Okay. And how many times are you updating this?
We actually usually only update it. There's two times we update it. Once a quarter is probably on average, and that's really just to update websites. Every once in a while, we'll do it if there's like a high priority thing that changes. But in general... Yeah, once a quarter, and again, you don't have to do that every quarter because it's not that big a deal, but it does come, the new one is obviously with all the new drivers too. So if you get the new driver, you automatically get the next and latest app priority list.
Okay. So this is the settings menu. So first thing you need to do, and I repeat again, I see some new people joining. You need to set the speed limits over here to get the best bandwidth priority, let's say like that. Yep. Wi-Fi analyzer, I think this is obvious. You see all the wireless networks over here and the signal strength. So you can choose the best network if it's available for you. You see here we have, like what you said, you know, all the networks are fighting.
Yep.
So what you want to do, and by the way, the router generally controls your channel, but it, you know, a little more technical, but if you can pick a channel that doesn't have a lot of other access points on it, just as a high level recommendation, that will be good for you from a wireless perspective.
Yeah. Popping up.
By the way, 2.4 and 5, just to be clear, the 2.4 goes a little further. 5 has a little more throughput. 5 is usually cleaner. So if you have a chance to pick up between 2.4 and 5, most cases 5 is going to be a better choice for you.
And new technology, the AX, will that have the 5 speed but further range?
Yes. So yes. 11X will be a 5 technology, and you'll do a much better job. And 5, just to let, I mean, again, there's a bazillion devices on 2.4, and when I say a bazillion, I mean a lot.
Yeah. It's 3 zillion.
Yeah, 5 is a much cleaner place to be.
Okay, so what I'm going to do, let me see, I have here some test files for download. So I'm just going to download something.
And you see the traffic move. All right.
Yeah. So this is on a mobile connection. What if I use Chrome, for example, and I do YouTube over here to watch a YouTube movie? Not sure what will be popping up.
Look pretty clean.
Yeah.
Thank goodness.
Should have thought about that.
Can you go to the apps page real quick, Eric? There's an apps page right below. There's actually show you the individual traffic per...
So what I want to ask, you know, because maybe this is not possible. I'm now going to play a movie. Let me skip. Ah, this is not a skippable. Oh yeah. Okay, so it's a 1080p. Doesn't. Oh. Mm-hmm. Let's play 4K video. It's actually a 4K screen on this GT75 notebook, but it will be streamed to 1080p. So.
Sure.
Let me go back. Yeah. So this is 4K video, and here we're still downloading the 2 gigabyte file. So, but it's all Chrome. Can I make a difference in Chrome? So the one window I do via the wireless solution, and the other one via the wireless solution.
So Chrome. So we can do two things. One is with Chrome, we can generally prioritize the different tabs separately.
Okay.
So if you have YouTube versus a Netflix, you can prioritize those separately. For YouTube specifically, it's one general connection, so they have to go over the same for Chrome. The app has to go over a single interface, but then inside of the app, it can be differentiated between different streams.
Okay. Now both is going via my mobile connection, and this is lagging. How do I get this on the wired network?
If you want to put it on the wireless network, wired network, you want to switch. So right now, can you read me the priority? Is priority 4?
Now it's priority 6.
Okay, then put it on priority 2, for example.
Yeah.
That'll just tell you you're gonna switch. So if you put 2, and then you restart you have to restart. So the next connection will move it over wired. So if you go to another YouTube video, for example, okay. Actually, if you wouldn't mind, just to make sure, can you prioritize it on 1, and then basically, yeah, go and do a different YouTube. Pick one that should. There you go.
Okay. Yeah.
So automatically switches over there. And it looks like in this case, wired, you have some more throughput there. So it's using a lot more wired right now.
I think now it's not. Yeah, it's also 4K. Oh, nice.
And so this is about the right bandwidth for a 4K. You see it bursting between 10 and 40, and that's about right.
Yeah. That is interesting. So, and now I'm going to fire up a game. Boot up the game. Can I go back to this control panel? So with alt up?
Yeah, you froze. Yeah. Yeah. Two things. If you want to, what you want to do is your game will automatically come as a 1. So you probably want to move your Chrome back to a 6 or a different priority.
Okay.
And then start up your game. It'll automatically detect it. Should detect it as a 1.
Okay. So I'm going to take Trackmania Turbo. I never played this game, so I was a little bit checking out the controls, but it's quite a funny game. Let's see how it's doing.
Never played.
I hope it's working. Yeah, it's working. Cool. Probably on the stream we will not have sound. I didn't look into that. So let me check some questions. Do you think Killer is a revolution or only one single step, and why?
What's that?
Did you say is Killer a revolution?
Yeah. Do you think this Killer is revolution or only a single step? So he's actually, is this just a step in the complete process of optimizing the network bandwidth, or is this, you made the biggest step already, and it will be evolution from here?
I think on the PC side, we've done a lot of the work. Now, the interesting part with networking is there's so many different steps. So that's why we came out with the router, because we really do think there's more to do from a complete kind of ecosystem standpoint on how to optimize. So again, the router to us is actually the most logical next step. There are certainly things we're still going to add and do on the PC side, especially as people get higher and higher bandwidth limits into their house. So I would say, look for improvement on the PC side, but we also are trying to attack other problems in the network, being the router and additional parts of it.
Okay.
Hey, Eric, out of curiosity, are you able to do a similar demo on the TI3 desktop there?
No, I didn't have it. Well, no, I, to be honest, I don't have it connected, so I don't know if there's any game on site, but yeah. Normally.
The only reason I mention it is one thing the E2500 has going for it versus the killer solution on the GT75 is We detect individual websites. When the apps tab, you would actually see a YouTube website in addition to Chrome. But anyways, that's the only big difference.
Ah, okay.
It would show up.
So, I'm just, you know, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just, yeah, clear.
You're just going to be driving, and we're going to watch your awesomeness here.
Don't bet on that. Well, actually, I want to Alt-tab. I hope the capture card is picking this up. So, the game. So here I have the game, indeed, like what you said, it's priority one. So priority one, it's now green, which means it's on the wired network, correct?
Go to the apps tab, if you could.
This is super interesting. If you look at the game,
yeah,
the amount of traffic a game takes is, you can play around and play it, but it's literally almost none.
Yeah.
So sometimes you'll see traffic, sometimes you won't. If you're moving around, you'll see traffic, but usually you only see, I don't know, let's call it 30 to 100 kilobits.
Oh, I can play this Windows. Yeah, I almost don't see any traffic.
Yeah. And that's the interesting thing about gaming. And, you know, Eric, for people who don't know this, if people do turn off everything else on their network because they're gaming, this is the reason why they shouldn't do that. I mean, they're basically turning it off for something that takes no traffic.
Yeah, indeed. So let's go back to the control panel. So over here I see a block item, so I can just click block and it will disable the network traffic for this one.
Yes. So there's two things you can do here. One is you can block if you don't know what it is, or you just don't want it. And then two is all of those scroll bars, that's actually real-time traffic. You can actually pull the scroll bar over,
okay,
and it will
yeah.
limit traffic to any application. So let's say you only want a certain website yeah. to get a certain amount. It will peg it out there in a...
Yeah, I limited the download process from, let me see, you see it's going up, 20 megabit. It's completely, fully using the wired of wireless solution. So now yep. going to limit it to like 50%.
Yep, it takes a couple seconds to stop it, but yeah, then it's limited to...
Oh, nice, and also the upload speed.
Yeah, and just one thing to be clear, that this does provide some benefit to the end user and they can do it, but even if you don't do this, we still do a really good job prioritizing the traffic. So don't think as a user you have to go in here and, you know, move a million things. You can if you want to optimize.
Okay. Yeah.
But it will be pretty good just on the default.
You guys are already doing this automatically.
This tab is really for the user who, you know, if you think like a video producer, a music producer, you know, who has the equalizer where they want to tweak all the settings and find the perfect balance, that's what this is for. You don't have to, but if you want to, it's there.
I have a question from Lorenzo. Is Killer Control program a paid program? And where can we have it? No, sorry, this is not a paid program. This is part of the Killer solution. So if you have one product, like a motherboard or a system or a notebook with a Killer networking solution, either wired or wireless on it, the software comes with it. So the software alone will not do anything, right?
Correct. You need the hardware.
Okay. Another question from Dan Sabado. Sorry if I pronounce it incorrect. Will the Killer prioritization engine in the WRT32X help consoles? He's talking Xbox, PlayStation.
The short answer is yes. There's two ways that it will. One of which is when that firmware update comes out that I mentioned that's going to come out this summer that will detect traffic from other devices. I believe Linksys is also in the process of launching an Xbox version of the router that's designed to detect Xbox traffic and do some similar things. If you're into consoles in addition to PC gaming, you know, it will offer benefits. And by the way, you know, it's funny. My son he likes to game on a PC when he's really trying to win, but when he wants
Jennings? Hello? There you are. Well, you already see that a streaming PC is not powered by Killer. So you're back. So you were talking about your son?
Oh, I was just going to say yes. My son sometimes games on a PC and sometimes he games on an Xbox to game with his friends. And so if you're a household like mine and you have both, the WRT32X is a great option.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Somebody saying Killer died. Well, no, it's not powered by Killer. We just have another PC, a streaming PC, which is capturing everything. How does this work with the LAN manager? Will they interfere with each other, or can it lead so that Killer will optimize? Let me check. I think he's asking about MSI Gaming LAN Manager, which is something different. So now today we're talking about Killer products, which is both hardware and software combined. And MSI Gaming LAN Manager is only software.
Yeah, it's pretty good that you're getting some pretty good advantages with just this as a statement. There's a lot of traffic shaping out there in the world. Tweaktown actually did a really nice article comparing several different traffic shaping engines. So if you're interested, check out the Tweaktown article with the E2500 versus other traffic shaping engines.
Yeah, it's on our website in our press section to make it easy.
So I have another question from, let me see, Robert Stevens. Is this a DNS-driven cloud quality of service system, QoS?
No, so what we basically do is we're optimizing the two things. We're optimizing the endpoint, and then we're tagging packets for the rest of the network. So everything that we do is detected and prioritized on the endpoint.
Okay.
So you know, we detect it's Call of Duty or World of Warcraft or whatever it is. We basically look at the network queue and all that kind of different things, and we optimize differently based on the type of application it is. Then we tag the packet so the rest of the network knows. But yeah, so it's all local, no DNS needed.
Okay, so for the software, anything else what I can demo? I think now it's pretty clear, when I start, for example, in a browser, I still have it on here, the download process, 2 gigabit files downloading, I have a YouTube movie playing at 4K resolution. And then I started the game. The game is automatically put on priority 1 and switch to the, let me see, then I go over here. Switch to the wired solution, here you can see. Green is Killer multi-gig. So in this product, actually, we have a multi-gig solution. We didn't talk about that yet. So this is the GT75 VR.
Yeah, absolutely. It's got.
So what is the multi-gig solution? That's a gigabit LAN or 10 gigabit LAN, right?
That's 10 gigabit. So,
okay.
So you'll see, I mean, it's actually interesting. The Ethernet's getting faster, that's for sure. And it turns out, in our mind, what's driving it is actually faster Wi-Fi, because Wi-Fi is,
it's everywhere.
Everywhere. Mm-hmm. Everywhere. So you'll see these faster AX and these faster AC speeds really driving Ethernet to go faster. And so we have a 10 gigabit solution with MSI today, which we're really proud of. You do need, just to let everyone know, for any multi-gigabit, the switch or the other thing you hook it up to has to also be that fast in order to really get the benefit of the traffic.
Clearly here it's not connected. Those are also quite still expensive, right?
Yeah, but starting in the next year, they're going to go down in at least multi-gigabit. We're going to offer 2.5 and other variations are going to come back to normal pricing. But they are fast, and certainly for some use cases, they're very valuable.
Yeah, but also for gamers, because you need probably like Cat 7 cables, also
you
expensive.
Can do them with Cat 6. Now they have a 10-base T technology that lets you do with Cat 6. But I will tell you, if you have 10 gig and you have a, let's call it a 200 megabit internet connection, mm-hmm. it will not help your game at all. And the reason I say that is because what one of the things Killer does really well is it, and by the way, so the 10 gig with Killer will work great for games, but the reason it'll work great is because Killer is managing your broadband connection. So your broadband connection, whether it's 10 megabits or 100 megabits, that is your golden link for the game to play fast. And so even with 10 gigabits, you still need prioritization, you still need traffic management, because what you're trying to do is optimize that 10, 50, 100 megabit link. where 10 or 2.5 really becomes valuable is, you know, moving things around the house, because it's not going to make your broadband speed any faster. What it's going to do is let you move traffic around the house faster.
We see two types of people really gravitate toward the 10 gig solution. And the two type of people are this, one of which is sort of the prosumer who really has a great home network set up and who wants to move files around his house or his office, you know, very quickly. The other is, you know, frankly, the gamer, the enthusiast, who just wants the best and the fastest. And, you know, this is a great option for both those people.
Yeah, so I guess my only last comment is you need, 10 is great, and killer with 10 gig is still absolutely needed and required to make your game play fast, because increased speeds don't, I mean, we talked about it, games are 30 kilobits, so having both is the best of, it's kind of all worlds.
Yeah. So I'm playing around here. Still, you know, I'm sorry, this game, I don't know, I'm not a racer. I mean, I keep crashing into the walls. But yeah, it's true, you know, you almost don't see any traffic for the games. So it's more having them smooth in to have a low ping. So also, you know, what is ping actually? Because a lot of people are saying, hey, I have a high ping. Will Killer also help with that?
Yeah, no, so ping is basically, it is the round trip time it takes a packet to go from
back in most and forward. Cases,
yeah, back and forth in a circle from you to the server and back. And yeah, so like we talked about, there's the system, there's the internet, and there's the game server. Those are where latency exists, basically. And Killer absolutely reduces the latency on the system. It helps with the network and the router because it's prioritizing and tagging packets so the network can see it.
Yep.
We don't have a lot of impact on the game server, but you know, we're able to kind of, you know, completely impact one, kind of impact that middle part, and then the game server will be what it is. But yeah, you'll absolutely reduce latency with a Killer product, especially when doing more than one thing at the same time on your PC.
Yeah, I have a question from Dan. Let me see. Does Killer Networking Adapter support aggregation or NIC teaming? I think that's like Double Shot, right? But Double Shot Pro is even better.
I would argue Double Shot Pro is even better. So what Double Shot Pro does is it takes an individual connection and it moves it over a certain link, whether it's wired or wireless. So you actually have to run two different apps in order to be able to use Double Shot, because one's going over one link, one's going over the other.
Jeroen, maybe you can go back to the Double Shot slide. I think that makes it more clear for everybody.
And so the one thing I'll describe is how it's different than teaming. So real link aggregation or teaming, what it's basically doing is it's sending one app over two interfaces and then trying to rebuild those packets on the other side. I will tell you, there, like Microsoft Server Edition, because you need something on the other side to reorder the packets. That is actually really, really hard to do. You need usually a pretty high-end switcher router, you know, an SMB, small, medium business one, or a server system to reorder those packets. For the average user who is trying to hook it up to another PC in their home, link aggregation doesn't actually work because they can't reorder the packet. So we think DoubleShot is the best of all worlds. You can use both links at the same time. You can get full throughput. There's no reordering problem on the other side. And it's just kind of easy and intuitive to use.
We were actually laughing, Eric. One time we saw one of your competitors put an ad up that said, you know, great for teaming. It's talking about their motherboard. It had one of our competitors had two LOMs on there, you know, two Ethernet ports. It said, great for teaming, and it showed two Ethernet ports, and then there's an asterisk. It said, teaming not supported by Windows.
Yeah, you're not only depending on the hardware, but also on the software. Also, Adrie is asking, is this useful for overclocking? No. Nothing to do with overclocking, right?
They work nicely together, but yeah, we don't overclock anything specific.
This Chris Grant has an interesting question. Will there be killer wireless thumb drives in the future for all the PCs so that if you don't have a slot available, you can still upgrade your PC? Nice idea, right?
Yeah, you mean like a dongle, right?
Yeah. Thumb drive, yeah. Dongle, you know, USB key.
We're definitely looking into it. That's probably
always. Would USB speed be enough? I mean, it would be limited to 10 megabits,
yeah,
right?
Type C, like that should be, that's fast. We'd like it to be like a Type-C or USB 3.1, but yeah, you can go pretty quick.
Interesting. Latency, yeah. Joe Barnett is asking, what is the latency difference between cable and fiber?
Oh, that's a tough one.
It depends on the implementation, right? On what kind of server is on the other side.
Yeah, it's actually interesting. Your network has a bunch of little hubs in it that basically is it goes from your carrier to a hub to another hub to another hub to the server. The actual thing that adds the most latency of the network is how many hubs you have to go through to get to the final server. So the most direct path is usually what is the fastest. Unfortunately, that's really hard to figure out. But I mean, fiber is definitely faster than copper by a little bit. But I'll tell you, the biggest difference is the number of hops your packet has to take in order to get to the final destination.
Yeah. Let me see. I think this is also a good question to give away. So Dan, thanks for your question. If you post your email address, I will copy paste it. We will send something to you, something really nice. You won a prize. Well, here you can see it already. So guys, we still have one prize to give away. Come up, good questions. And then I think, do you still want to talk about something? I think we touched most points, right?
I think we hit really all the points we were hoping to cover, and I think the questions added a lot of value.
A lot of questions. Let me see. Will Killer There be also on MSI Day, 9th of June? I think this is in, let me see, which country? Crazy. Which country? Let me check. I think it's in Holland. They have an MSI Fan Day, 9th of June. Or maybe Computex. Will you guys be in Computex?
I'll be at Computex, we'll be at Computex.
Okay, so, well, then you cannot be in Holland, because I see in Holland on the 9th of June they have an MSI Fan Day, game day, here in Eindhoven. I see now, thanks. No, they will not be there. This is an interesting question, Marek. Is there any minimum speed that you need to benefit from Killer?
No, I mean, honestly, we have people, it's actually interesting how Killer works. It works on all pipes. We certainly have people with 1.5 megabit connections that have specifically bought Killer because every single packet matters in their performance. So yeah, as low as you want to go. I mean, you can have a dial-up modem and we will help you out.
Yeah, up until about a year and a half ago, I had a 5 megabit connection, and Killer was great on a 5 megabit connection because, you know, when you have that little, you know, even YouTube videos need to be prioritized right to keep them smooth and fast. So, at least a high resolution.
A moment, let me send a message to Dan. So Dan, congratulations. You can delete your email address. I copy paste it, and I will contact you later this week to ask you for more details. Thank you. So guys, we're coming to the end of the live stream. If there's still any question, please let us know in the chat. Let me see. Yeah, I think we did a live demo, etc. We touched all points. So we talked about wired solutions, wireless solutions. We talked about DoubleShot Pro, that you can combine everything. We talked about the software. We talked about multi-gig. So multi-gig. It's like what we have on this godlike motherboard with three LAN connectors, Wi-Fi, so you can connect everything in your house to your PC, so it actually acts like a hub to optimize all the traffic inside your house. Let me check.
You know, the only thing I just want to remind people who may have kind of logged in later to the stream is
that's always the problem with live stream, you know, you get a lot of double questions.
Absolutely.
What we already talked about, and then if we this is an interesting question. Sorry, first you.
Oh, I was just going to say, just remind them, killernetworking.com is where to go for tech support from us. If you have any questions or problems, we also have a Facebook page. We answer questions at. We really usually refer tech support away from Facebook to our to our website. But if you have anything, those are great ways to reach us.
Yeah, let me quickly check this.
And if you haven't tried Killer for a while, like if you're a couple generations where you haven't tried it, I certainly recommend you do. I mean, the performance, the stability, the quality has all just been awesome in our mind for the last few years. So anyway.
I totally agree with this. In the past, there were a lot of negative comments, and you guys touched that, fixed it, and improved on it. And that's very important. One question from Chris. He's asking the... What is it? Universal Windows Program, right? UWP. Yeah, so are you going to have only that version, or will there be two versions in the future?
For the near term, we'll have both. It really depends on our partners, what we do in the future. I mean, UWP is clearly where Microsoft is going, so we will absolutely support that. We actually are in the process of getting that out into the field today.
So and this also means it will be in the Windows Store. It will be automatically updated, correct? Yeah.
Yes. Correct. I mean, by the way, UWP for us is great because with Windows 10 and how it updates so fast, and you know, users are having a problem, you know, staying up to date with the drivers and the app and all that kind of stuff. UWP solves a lot of those problems by, you know, letting our stuff update more regularly, also keep kind of a good pattern between micro killer updates. So is a good advantage.
Will you not be limited by I think, you know, I'm not a programmer or I'm not an expert, but UWP, when it came out, a lot of game developers were complaining. So will you not be limited by having the touching the raw performance of the throughput? Will there be any limitations, or will the performance be the same?
Performance will be exactly the same. We spend a lot of time with Microsoft, an absolute lot. And there were some things that initially came out that were problematic for us and others.
Okay.
Those have been fixed, and we feel really good about where it stands today.
Yeah.
Okay, interesting. One last, let me check. Yeah, I think that's it.
So Eric, if you want me to, I can type my name into the live, my email address in the live stream, and you can ship me that motherboard. That would be awesome.
Yeah, well, what we're going to do, let me see, how does affect MSI software cable Windows? How does that affect MSI software from issues created by Windows updates like in past April? Can you be, Taylor, can you be a little bit more clear, please?
By the way, just one comment on that comment is Windows updates absolutely create problems. So sometimes we've had a couple where, you know, sometimes people blame us, sometimes people blame Windows, but there are Microsoft controls more networking than they previously did. So getting their automatic updates, getting our updates is crucial because, I mean, there was two major bugs that Microsoft introduced last year that were networking bugs that were not created.
I'm still here. Can you hear me? I think we need to upgrade our streaming PC with a killer solution, guys. This is Skype-y. I know sometimes, and especially with video, you know, sometimes we have that. So you drop for the last for the last half hour. No. For the last minute, you dropped out.
My point was just like there has been bugs. There were some major networking bugs introduced by Microsoft in the last year. There was two of them, frankly. They got fixed really fast, but that is one of the reasons why we do recommend updating drivers. You know, a lot of times Microsoft will be like, "Hey guys, sorry," or you know, we figure out there's a bug. We can update it really quick on Killer, but it takes us longer to get our update process out there because we have to refresh all the time. So if you see anything, we put knowledge base articles real quick. Usually when we see things like that, we post drivers real quick. So any issues, contact us, download the newest driver, and we'll get fixes out. But again, Microsoft Killer and Microsoft and the rest of the PC ecosystem are doing this constant dance trying to optimize for each other. And it is it's challenging, but I think overall good for the user.
So what I'm going to do, we still have, I wanted to take this one, but not this motherboard. We still have a Z270 Gaming M7 to give away, also with Killer networking on there. So I'm going to give it to the most active user on our chat, which is Marek. He asked a lot of questions. I think I only touched two questions from him. I'm sorry, Marek. But you can go home with this nice motherboard. So let me see, Marek, please post your email address so I can contact you.
So that's a cool motherboard, by the way. We have that motherboard in our lab. We love it. We have people fight over it. It's a really great motherboard.
Well, he can go home with it, so he probably has to reinstall his PC in order to use it. But I'm sure he will be happy. So, Marek, please post your email address. I will later this week, I will contact you. So, guys, this was it for this week. Next week, we're going to do some State of Decay 2 gameplay. It's a new game from Microsoft. We can play it with four people. I hope we can fit four people over here, or I can find three more friends. I'm not sure. Should be awesome. So next Wednesday again, same time. Thank you, Marek, for posting. I will let me first copy paste that. Yeah. Thank you. You can delete it. So Mike, Bob, thank you for joining so early morning, and really great to have you on. A lot of interesting information, a lot of background information. And yeah, I think now it's clear to everybody why we love killer networking solutions so much. And I think a lot of products from MSI come with killer networking. And I'm really happy, you know, that you're open again for feedback and for questions. So for people who just joined, you know, just go to killernetworking.com, right? Let me post the link one more time. killernetworking.com. There's a support page, so if you have any questions or if you have any game where you do, I saw some people, you know, asking Halo or Counter-Strike, you know, it's adding some lag, or what should I do to optimize the game, just contact I don't think Mike and Bob will be answering your emails, probably somebody else, but for sure, you know, their support team will help you out, and we'll try to figure it out, and we'll make Killer even more great again. So thanks, Mike. Thanks, Bob.
We have to monitor the tickets.
Yeah, so we answer lots of emails. It's funny. We're gamers too, so we want to get a touch for in touch with what's going on with end users. So please send them over, even if you just want to chat about something or ask a networking question. Feedback makes our products better. So keep it up, and we're very interested.
Okay, thank you both for joining, and have a good day over there.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for joining, for all the questions, and see you next week, Wednesday, 4 p.m., State of Decay 2 gameplay. Bye-bye.
Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Kill.